The gloves are off now in the 2020 presidential campaign, with the president and former vice president both hitting the trail today in Iowa, then squarely setting their sights on each other. All right, let's talk about who had the better day with Senator Tom Tillis, Republican of North Carolina. Great to have you with us tonight.
Good to be back.
All right, we'll play a little recap for folks about the two, many say, leading contenders at this point, going after each other in Iowa.
Joe never got more than 1%, except Obama took him off the trash heap. No, I'd rather run against, I think, Biden than anybody. I think he's the weakest mentally. And I like running against people that are weak mentally. I think Joe is the weakest up here.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat. America was built in the way we were built, basic core values, decency, honor, leaving no one behind, realizing that there are things that are bigger than you in America, that we have to get together, we have to cooperate. But this is a guy who does everything to separate and frighten people. It's about fear and loathing.
Okay, so that's how the two of them pair up against each other today. I want to also point out the Quinnipiac University poll that came out. The president against a number of the top Democrats. Let's start with the former vice president. It shows him with a 13 percentage point lead over the president.
Well, I think a lot of people, we've got to look at what the election, how it unfolds next year. If you remember back in the 80s, everybody counted out President Reagan. His numbers were 15, 20 points behind his opponents. It became a landslide. I think the president runs on his record. He runs on fighting China's unfair trade practices. He runs on securing the border. He runs on good economic numbers. He gets reelected.
So from the National Journal today, the headline, "Why Trump Isn't Likely to Win a Second Term." Democrats can lower expectations all they want, but polls show the president facing a decisive defeat. Josh Krasauer writes this: Trump is in the weakest political shape of any sitting president since George H.W. Bush. He says that's despite the economy. He goes on to say, Trump's clearest path to victory relies on Democrats making a series of self-destructive decisions. But even if Democrats turn leftward and nominate a weak challenger, they'd still have a credible chance at unseating Trump.
I don't buy it. I think that's pre-election year rhetoric. I think the president runs on a strong record. I believe that the American people like somebody who's fighting for him. Farmers in Iowa, farmers in North Carolina feel good about what the president's doing for them. I think once he's able to turn his attention to China and get a fair trade deal with them, and we secure the border, and we continue the great economic success, that's a winning formula for next year.
Okay, so obviously you have a race, too. There are some primary contenders making a lot of noise and people talking about the fact that you're now supportive of the president, maybe not always that way. One website says this: facing primary challenge, once proud Rhino Tom Tillis converts to MAGA. They say it's a strange about face for Tillis, who once had a reputation for defying the president. Goes on to say, it looks like the Tillis campaign has decided on a straightforward strategy: defend the president as much as possible and hope that dissatisfied conservatives will forget about his previous transgressions. How do you respond?
I don't much care about the bloggers, you know, the folks that are trying to divide our party. The fact of the matter is, I have a 95% lifetime voting record with Donald Trump. This isn't a turnaround. President Trump's been good on policies. I voted with him. We're going to continue to work to support his agenda. He and I have very different styles, but when it comes to policy priorities, I'm there. They go out to 538, go out to the sites that track our votes, and they'll see that I've been a consistent supporter. I get to vote twice on all the judicial nominations because I'm on the Judiciary Committee. Voted for all the great nominees coming through Judiciary, the cabinet post. I've got a record that I'm not running from. I'm running on it. That's why we're going to win in any primary if we have one, and we'll win in the general election.
Well, it'll be an interesting year for all of us in the next 18 months or so. Senator, thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
Good to have you.